So there's been an announcement that the fourth Star Trek film in the Kelvin universe is now greenlit after being stuck in development limbo for over a year now. And according to Bounding Into Comics, Legion and Fargo creator Noah Hawley is to write and direct new Star Trek film. And Chris Pine is back as Captain Kirk, so that's very welcome indeed. So it's the same cast as the last three Trek films made under the J.J. Abrams Bad Robot production company. Very little else is known about the film, but I honestly couldn't be bothered to learn more about it. The 2009 film wasn't really Star Trek, in my opinion, in terms of the tone or the theme of it, but it was entertaining as a one-off, fun sci-fi action-adventure film, and I appreciated Leonard Nimoy's part in the film as the older Spock. But this film truly was, in my view, the beginning of the decline of the Trek franchise. I think the filmmakers really needed to actually produce something interesting in terms of story for their second installment, but Into Darkness was appalling. There was no Star Trek philosophy or thought-provoking element to the film. The breathless, brain-dead action, fast-paced editing, and copious amounts of on-screen visual effects seemed designed to distract the audience from thinking too much about the stupidity of the story and the myriad of plot holes. And I think the film does a disservice to its iconic characters and confirmed to me that the Bad Robot Trek films are nothing but brainless, high-octane popcorn sci-fi films, but with a Star Trek veneer. And to be honest, there's not much science in the science fiction either. These feel more like fantasy films set in space. Star Trek Beyond followed, and that was shockingly awful. I don't know where to begin. I think the only things that I remember about that film was that Sulu is now gay, the Enterprise was destroyed, Kirk was riding around on the planet on a motorbike for some reason, and the crew managed to defeat a swarm of spaceships with rock music. Star Trek films are no longer made for the hardcore, dedicated Trek fanbase. They're made for general audiences now, and therefore they've been dumbed down intellectually to the point of being just a bit of mindless fun. Some fun action scenes, some big explosions, some fight scenes, and a few quips and gags here and there. Whatever works as fodder for a cool movie trailer, I guess. It's about mass audience appeal. So that's why, in my opinion, modern Star Trek films feel the same as most average big-budget Hollywood action movies these days. Safe, bland, forgettable. Considering that Star Trek Beyond underperformed at the box office, I think the studio should consider maybe cutting the budget back a little bit in order to maximize profits and try to make a smaller film, which I personally think might be a good thing. I would welcome that. Necessity is, after all, the mother of invention. Less money might result in less reliance on big action set pieces, for example, thus requiring more of a focus on the quality of the story. So I wish them all the best with this project, but my expectations would be very low, especially after Into Darkness and Beyond. I find those movies unwatchable. Star Trek Beyond felt like the Star Trek version of Guardians of the Galaxy or something. And I don't really know if the interest is there among hardcore Trek fans for another one of these Kelvin timeline Bad Robot Trek films. I just don't think that this interpretation of Star Trek that we're currently getting at the moment is really what the fans actually want. So let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.